Hello, welcome to Buchli.com from Paris, France. Today, we're going to teach you how to make a cushion from a finished tapestry. These are the elements you need before starting. A sewing machine, the filling for the cushion, the tapestry itself, the material, a tape measure, scissors, pins, and lastly, an ironing board with the iron. The first step is to cut the canvas around the finished needlepoint, leaving about an inch of bare canvas all around, like this. Since the cushion will be larger than the tapestry, which is about 16 inches square, we need to cut 4 strips of material to add all around. To the 16 inches, we're adding 3 inches of material. 2 inches plus 1 inch for the seam. Each strip needs to be 28 inches long. In this instance, we have chosen a material, which is a pure silk, which matches the colors in our design. Here is what the strips, once they've been cut, should look like. Here, you want to be sure to line up the outside of each strip of material against the outside of the finished needlepoint. This is very important. Be sure to center line each strip on the tapestry. Place the tapestry with the strip in your sewing machine, like this. Start at the exact corner of the tapestry and carefully sew along the finished needlepoint, making sure no canvas will show when the seam is finished. Stop exactly at the next corner. Here is what the tapestry looks like with a strip of material sewn on. Make sure the sewing starts and stops at exactly each corner of the tapestry, like this. This is what the tapestry looks like with the 4 strips that have been sewn on before making the corners. Now the seams must be ironed so they are quite flat. Now we are going to fashion the corners. Put the tapestry down face up. Fold one strip on top of the other strip on a slant. Iron the corner so that it is perfectly flat. Now flip the corner to the inside, or the wrong side. And sew along the crease which has been formed by the iron. After you have finished making the corners, you can skip the next step, which is the addition of a ruffle, or include it as you wish. In this section, we're going to show you how to make the ruffle. To make the ruffle, cut 4 strips of material, 6 inches wide and 28 inches long. and sew those four strips one after the other so that they form a long circular ribbon like this. These strips have been folded in half lengthwise so that their width is now 3 inches. Sew this ribbon where the two strips join in order to form a tube. You must set your stitch width on your sewing machine to the widest possible width. On a single sewing machine, it is number 5. You will sew along the strip 2 times, 2 rows of sewing next to each other, but not on top of each other. You then take up this long circular ribbon and fold it in 4 parts. Mark each corner of these 4 strips with a pen. You then attach each part marked with a pen to each corner of the cushion. Make sure the right sides or the outsides are against each other. Now pull the threads in order to shape the ruffle. Remember, you sewed 2 rows of number 5 stitch, and you are pulling the threads until the ruffle is even with each side of the cushion. Do this very slowly and be careful not to break the threads. As you're pulling the threads, make sure you pull them together, both threads at the same time, so that the ruffle is even. While doing this, be very careful, do this slowly, and make sure that the ruffle is even with the strip. Now, pin the ruffle against each side of the cushion. Always put the right side of the ruffle against the right side or the outside of the cushion. Now the ruffle has been pinned, and this is what it looks like. Now you can sew the ruffle onto the cushion. Put the needle size back to small, 2 or 2.5, on your machine. This is what the cushion looks like so far. Now, cut a piece of material exactly the size of the surface, not counting the ruffle, plus 1 inch all around for the seam. In order to sew the back of the cushion, you must fold back the ruffle. Attach the material onto the outside part or the front part always the right side against the right side. Start sewing on the bottom of the cushion, leaving a space of about 8 inches. This is so you can turn the cushion right side out when you finish sewing, and also have enough room to insert the filler. Okay, now we have to turn the cushion outside out. Here we go. You can get a filling made into a cushion, which you can buy in a fabric store, or you can fill it with some other filler which comes in bags. When you finish filling the cushion, pin the whole closed. Now, you can sew the opening by hand. Here is what the finished cushion should look like. If you have any questions, please feel free to contact us at boucherie.com.